Hello, we are from Group 10, and I'm Muhammad Afiq Isaac, Ben Zulfi Musrianto, playing the act of Steven.
Hi, my name is Muhammad Rafaris, and I will be playing as Pete.
Hi, my name is Chia Michael Bishisa. I'll be playing as narrator and news reporter.
Hi, my name is Lee Z. So I'm going to act as Sir Jackson.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Dennis Najon Binhasto. I'm going to play the act of Professor Zaidin.
And this is for our assignment, the acting play. So enjoy your acting and miss, give us a good grade.
Enjoy.
Professor Zaidin and Sir Jackson are in their laboratory doing some research until the news on the screen caught their attention. Good evening, I'm Sean. We interrupt this broadcast of 69 Records on TV to bring you a breaking news of a virus outbreak just inside of town. This virus is known to affect people's minds and physical appearance. Everyone is advised not to go outside of the house and prepare any necessary supplies for a week.
Wait, what? That suspicious. It aligns with our research, just like fate. Wondering if the source is here.
What source?
Nothing. Just one of my research.
Well, we need to find it as soon as possible, so we will not spread.
Don't you worry. If you die, I'll be the first to know.
That's weird. It's suspicious.
Meanwhile, at the cafe.
Are you really watching this, Steve?
Yeah, it looks like the world might fall apart. And there could be a zombie apocalypse happening real soon.
Well, you know that zombies aren't real, right?
Chill. Anyway, so...
Suddenly, students can be heard screaming from all parts of school.
This is madness. We gotta quickly see Prof Z.
On their way to Prof Z's lab, the students panic along the school hallway. In the faraway distance, they saw a student get tackled by a person with a nasty appearance. He aggressively ripped the skin out of him. Guts and blood splattered around the school's wall.
Quick the door.
I'm trying. It will not open.
The size is pulled, not push. Yeah. Hurry up, you're getting closer.
Oops, yeah, my bad. I was panicking.
What do you want? My favorite student.
What's with the hurry?
Defected. They already spread all over the part of school. We saw those things hurry our friends. What are we going to do now? Is there any cure to this?
Don't you worry, pretty little mind. I've been preparing for this months before the news outbreak.
The infected from the outside struggle to break the front door and create a very loud noise.
Come here, follow me.
Peter and Steven follows Professor Zaidan. Suddenly, Steven stops walking.
OMG! What is that? It looks disgusting.
This thing is explicit. I can't share with anyone yet.
How come I never knew this before?
Now you know.
All of a sudden, the front door fell onto the floor. The infected rushed towards them as fast as lightning.
You didn't lock the door.
I thought they were dumb enough to open the door.
Follow me to the nearest emergency exit if you want to leave.
As they are running towards the exit, Steven trips onto the ground and his leg is being grabbed by the infected. He struggles for freeing himself.
Anyone?
The infected bites him on his left hand.
Steve!
Guys, hear me out. Guys, come on!
Peter kicks the infected to rescue Steven, while Sir Jackson closes and holds the door.
He needs a medic immediately.
We can help, but to just stay here, okay? It's getting crazy right here. Can't you see that? You know, the only way for Steven to survive is to chop off his left hand.
You're kidding, right? It's just a kid.
I mean, you know, this is between life and death. This to prevent the virus from spreading inside of him. So yes, quick, before he turns into one of those monsters. Do you want to see that?
The looks deep into Steven's eye, knowing he is suffering that much. He feels pity on him and suddenly remembers his promises. Steven was fighting over Peter as the football team lost the game.
You group is such a liar. Liar!
Not even being jealous to your friend's success.
I knew it. You were meeting it the whole time.
Wait.
Really?
Really? I don't say anything, to be honest.
Peter? Peter? Please answer me!
Steven continued to shake Peter's body as he was really worried about Peter's condition, wondering if he punched too hard on Peter's face. Peter was being hospitalized for about 3 days before finally waking up.
Peter? I thought I'm never gonna see you again.
Wait, what? What are you doing here? You're the one who brings me here.
Well, I'm really sorry what happened, you know, earlier. Do you forgive me about earlier?
Well, yeah, of course. We've been good friends for 6 years. Everyone made mistakes. They were meant to be forgiven.
Thank you so much, Peter. I know maybe, you know, like, I don't deserve all of this, you know.
Well, Steve, I have a thought. Would you do anything for me from us getting separated?
No, I won't promise, but I will do so.
Unfortunately, the infected managed to find their hiding place as they have already eaten too much brain, helping them to increase their IQ.
Cover your eyes, Steve.
I think I'm going past now.
Steve. It's the only solution we have right now.
Guys, does it work?
Is he going to turn?
It seems good to me.
Jackson, do you have like the first aid kit or somewhere, you know, to cover your blood?
Yes, on the shelf.
Alright, quick, wrap his arm with bandage.
Little did they know, chopping off Steven's left hand wouldn't stop the infection. While Peter was managing him, Sir Jackson slowly whispers to Prof Z, asking if that really stopped the infection.
Sir, you know, he won't make it for a long period of time. Shouldn't we tell them?
Just be quiet, you silly. It's best to let them know, so that they won't panic.
Sorry, Professor.
Steven seems like he can't survive anymore. The death is calling him. Peter can't look at his friend becoming like this. He starts to cry, knowing he will lose him forever.
I guess that's it. It's time for me to sacrifice my own friend to show how my loyalty.
My God. Oh, terrible.
Without any hesitation, Peter lets Steven bite his arm as he promised to die together. Professor Z drags the infected body and throws them into his secret basement, called as Lab Rats.
Now, it's your time.
What do you mean, my turn?
You know what? Sometimes, it's okay to stab your own partner. Hey, don't run!
Sir Jackson is eager to know the reason why Professor Zayden did this all. But Prof Z stabs Sir Jackson until he dies. In the end, Prof Z gets what he wants and continue to lie to other people.
Welcome to my lab, rats. Who's next?